Hello friends and good day. This is Fred with Tech Talk and I'm coming at you today with a quick video on smart motion detection, SMD, and what you can do to eliminate false motion activated recordings and alerts. We have a couple of comments by some of our subscribers who are pulling their hair out with ghost alarms. They're getting hundreds of alerts over the course of a night. When they do playback, there's nothing on video and they can't understand what the problem is. There's a simple solution to this. We're going to cover it right now. All right, what do you say? Let's get into the meat and potatoes. Before we do, you know the drill. There is a subscribe button in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. Please click that and subscribe to our channel so you'll be notified when we upload future content just like this. Also, like the video if it's useful. And as always, leave comments and questions. This video, as we already stated, is based on a subscriber comment. Okay, so yes, smart motion detection. Motion detection is very important when you review video looking for an incident. You don't want to go through 24/7 for a week looking for someone that damaged your property or may have stolen something from your shed. You want to look at alerts that are created by movement of people and vehicles and find that incident quicker. Okay. And not everybody sets up properly to do that. The first thing I'll tell you, I see these YouTube videos by yo-yos talking about hanging four cameras off of one Cat 5 cable, okay? So you're going to run one Cat 5 cable with four twisted pairs. You're going to put video balans on the end of each twisted pair and have four cameras run through one cable, okay? Common sense will tell you the camera's not designed to operate that way. Okay, Cat 5 is 24 gauge cable. It's very thin cable. Okay, so the first thing is use the proper wire. Okay, you're not going to save a buck by using one wire to run four cameras and get the full effectiveness of the camera. These cameras are designed for one cable, trust me. So if you're running IP cameras, home run wire the IP camera with a Cat 5e or Cat 6 cable, home run one direct wire directly to the PoE switch that's built into the NVR or your standalone PoE switch. If you're using analog equipment, same thing. Use an RG59 cable, a proper cable with 18-2 power cable. Hook it to a proper power supply box. You know, if it's a 9-channel power supply box, it should be 10 amps, okay? 12 volts, 10 amps. So you want to make sure you hook these things up. That's number one, use the proper equipment. There are SMD cameras. I'm gonna show you the difference between a SMD, smart motion detection camera, and a normal camera, okay? There's a minimal price difference. It's $20 or $30 a camera, but it makes a huge difference, okay? So the first thing we're gonna do is review a regular camera, a standard camera, and see what it records for as motion, okay? So let's go into playback here. And we will pick a property that has normal cameras, okay? And we'll do playback by, okay, we want to do playback by, not all recordings, but by motion detection, okay? And that will pull up just our motion activated recordings. And as you can see, there are only a couple from this location. So let's see. Based on the fact this is a standard camera, not a smart motion detection camera, let's see what we're getting for motion. Okay, oh, there it is right there. See the shadow in the snow? That's ghosting, right? It's not a person, it's not a car, it's something in the environment causing the motion, okay? Let's see what the second tick mark here on the bottom is. Oh, there it is, some smoke. Some smoke on the roof, okay? There is a truck in the background, but that's not what triggered this motion event. Let's look at the one more, the third hash mark, and see if this is a person or a vehicle. No, as you can see, more smoke, okay? So these are what we would call ghost alarms, okay? And that is standard data for a normal camera, okay? As with everything, you get what you pay for. So now let's switch to a location that does have a SMD camera, okay? This is a location that we installed from scratch. The Best Western, we actually took over. The wire was already run, and we were limited as to what we could put in there for equipment, okay? This location is all us. So again, it does have SMD, Smart Motion Detection, Dahua cameras. Let's see what we get for motion there. We'll do the main parking lot. And I would go out on a limb and say, hopefully, all of these are vehicles. We'll go through a couple of these and see what we get, okay? Number one is a car. That's good. We're off to a good start here. We'll see the second tick mark here in a minute. We'll see what that is. There's another vehicle there on the top left of your screen. 2 out of 2. It's a very clear, crisp picture too, these 4 megapixel cameras. There we have a dumpster truck, trash truck driving by. We'll try one more just to make sure there's no false motion. I apologize for taking up so much of your time. We just want to give you a good, equal comparison. Uh-oh. Mr. Policeman. Oh, he's doing an illegal U-turn. Do not do that with Big Brother watching. All right, we see you. All right, so as you can see by those two comparisons, SMD does work. Again, for the cost difference, in my opinion, it's well worth it. Also, most of these smart analytical cameras have night color view. So instead of infrared coming on at night, which is kind of a black and white picture with some green, it looks like military nods if you were in the military and put on nods. It's not a very crisp picture. These Dahua SMD cameras also have the night color, which is awesome. I wish I could show you the camera. It actually has 2 small spotlights that come on and shine very brightly when there's motion, almost acting as a virtual alarm to scare off intruders. So I definitely recommend that camera. So now you are going to say, well, that's great, Fred. How do I activate this smart motion control? We're going to do that by hitting the plus here. Okay. And we are going to go into device configuration. Okay. You're going to pick your location. Whoops. Shaking the laptop on you guys. Sorry. And we're going to make sure under event that motion is picked, first of all. So we'll pick event. We'll come to motion detect. And we'll make sure camera one has motion enabled. Okay. So you'll want to do that. You'll want to make sure that the motion is triggering the proper channel. Okay, so motion on channel 1 should record on channel 1. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go and use the link to the web browser. If you've watched previous videos of mine on Dahua, I love this function. You can actually click this button and it will open up the recorder in a browser as though you are logging in to the recorder itself on site, which is awesome. Hikvision, HIK Connect has nothing like this, okay? So we'll log into the camera here, and we will go into the top right-hand corner, okay? These are the smart analytics settings, okay? And what we want to do, if you look down on the bottom, there will be an SMD icon, okay? We want to go into parameters, and we want to click SMD. And in the setting, we can enable channel 1, smart motion, and we can tell it to target, okay? We want to target humans and motor vehicles. Okay. There's also a sensitivity setting. Okay. You can go low, medium, or high. I have found medium works perfect in most locations, as long as you're not trying to track vehicles, you know, 200 or 300 yards away. Okay. I definitely would suggest this. Post record is how many seconds after the motion triggers the recording does the camera or recorder record that segment. Okay, so 10 seconds is generally good. And we're just going to hit apply. Okay, it's as simple as that. Once you do that, these SMD cameras will only activate recording and alerts if it's a vehicle or a person. Okay, and it's very accurate. I would say it's 95% accurate. Every now and then you'll see something crazy that's out of the norm that will record, but for the most part it really is, even in New England where we have snow, vehicles and people. There are links in the description to this video for SMD cameras, for this particular camera, the 4-megapixel dome. You can actually put up to 256 gigabit of micro SD card in this camera and use it as a standalone solution without a recorder. If you're doing 1, 2, 3, 4 cameras. If you want a NVR, there are SMD NVRs, okay? There's also a link to the SMD NVR series in the description to this video. These cameras also have two-way audio, okay? So you can hear what's going on and speak through the camera, which I think is very cool. So, all right, that includes everything to do with SMD, smart motion detection, and these smart cameras. We're going to have a video, probably our next video coming out in the near future, that will cover people counting with these same cameras. You can actually, I call it a draw in a line in the sand, but you can draw an intrusion line, and every time a person crosses that, the camera can count for you. This is great for retail stores if you're trying to calculate conversions and foot traffic and stuff like that. So look for that coming out in the future, and we'll see you in the field.